Hippies!
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 During the 1960s, hippies shocked America with their alternative lifestyle and radical beliefs. They were young people who enjoyed life to its fullest. They used illegal drugs and listened to rock and roll music. With their alternative beliefs and practice, they stunned America conservative middle class. Concerned chiefly protesting the Vietnam War and with the civil rights, they made a huge impact on America and the world. Even today, the effects of the hippie movement is still felt, made huge advantages, and set complex for the youth of today and years to come.
Hippies' trademark was their distinctive clothing style, where they wore jeans, tie-dye shirts, sandals, and long hair. Their lifestyle can be characterized by sex and drug culture. They embrace sexual promiscuity and recreational drugs such as marijuana and LSDs. In 1964, in University of California at Berkeley, the free speech movement was formed, where they protested by tactics such as sit-ins and taking over the college buildings. In one of the protests, the governor sent 600 armed policemen and stopped the protest, which set fire on students all over the United States. Just in the first 6 months of 1968, more than 200 major demonstrations took in 100 universities and colleges all over the United States, which included more than 40,000 students. Counterculture's demonstrations were mostly focused on against the Vietnam War, but that was not the only issue they protested. They had several issues that they protested before the Vietnam War was its hot topic. The issues were influenced by the manifesto known as a Port Huron Statement that focused on student and individual rights, economic justice, and social reform.
In the 60s, the political climate was very extreme. The hippie movement changed the politics and the culture in America in the 1960s. It began in San Francisco, California, and across the US, Canada, and parts of Europe. Most were whites, middle-class, college-aged people from age 15 to 25. After 1963, things started to slowly change in how America viewed its politic culture and social beliefs. And the group that was in charge of this change seemed to be the Youth of America, the Civil Rights Movement, President Kennedy's death, new music, the birth control pill, the growing illegal drug market, and the Vietnam War seemed to blend together to form a new counterculture in America, the hippie. The hippie left their families for many reasons. They rejected their parents' ideas. They wanted to get away from them, and etc. Many of them were inspired by President John Kennedy and Martin Luther King.
Ask not what your country can do for you. Ask what you can do for your country.
Trust the government. During the Vietnam War, most of the poor American men were drafted and sent to the war, based on a lie, and many of them came back in boxes. Hippies often participated in peace movements. The hippie did not try to change America through violence. The hippie tried to change things through peace and love. Mostly they were energetic and idealistic. They were Jewish, Catholic, Protestant, Muslim, and Buddhist. The skin color, religion, male or female did not matter. What mattered was idea, music, and protest. They thought that the Vietnam War was enormously wrong. Many of them lived in California and made other Americans realize that most of the nation's population had shifted to the West. The hippie movement had new and different preference in music called rock and roll. Rock and roll is a type of music that evolved from earlier jazz music. This type of music took counterculture topics such as peace and drug use and put it into lyrical form. and most known 1960s rock concert started on August 15, 1969, the Woodstock Music and Art Festival, which included 3,000 to 4,000 people. The counterculture in the United States reached its peak between 1966 and the early 1970s. It eventually waned for several reasons. Mainstream America's disdain for an dependent hedonism and conspicuous drug use, and the troubles caused by those excesses. The death of many notable counterculture figures, the end of the Vietnam War, and the end of the civil rights protest following passage of remedial legislation. The counterculture continues to influence social movements, art, and society in general.
As the 1960s progress, the youth in America is united. In 1969, 400,000 young people materialized for 3 dizzying days to listen to rock and blues music, to wear funny clothing or no clothes at all, to talk, sing, dance, clap hands, to drink beer or smoke pot and make love, but mostly to marvel again and again that they were all together. The hippie movement was called the counterculture because it rejected the prevailing social norms. Culturally, they swept away the social mores of previous generations. They experimented with alternative lifestyles using guideposts of love, peace, and understanding to light the way. They liberated both sex and love from conventional stereotypes and found their deeper meaning, a way to connect the universal energy. They learned activism and organized and demonstrated against Vietnam War. Their art, music, and literature stand above the garbage produced by recent mass of consumer culture. Being a hippie is much more difficult than others. They accept a higher level of social, ecological, ethical and moral responsibility than most people who are willing to accept.
Thank you!
Do you believe in magic? In a young girl's heart, how the music can free her whenever it starts, and it's magic. If the music is groovy and makes you feel happy like an old-time movie, I'll tell you about the magic and the free your soul.